Good morning, Tuesday. Great to have you with us today. It is Tuesday, April 13th. Hard to believe is the middle of April already. Can you believe it? How fast time travels. It is going quickly. Good morning, Kenya. Good morning, y'all, and welcome to a Tuesday edition of Jessie Clark Fitness. We have our upper body circuit for you today. So Monday is always full body. Good morning, Catherine, Jackie, Barbara, Becky, the gang's here, Eric is here. Good morning, y'all. All right, Shanette, waking up early on a Tuesday. Proud of you guys. Kim made it, Ranja's here. Shanette checking in. Good to see you guys. So we have an upper body circuit today. It's supersets. Catherine's here. So we've got two movements back to back, and what we're gonna try to do is go back to back to back to back. And then at the end of that superset, we will take a break. Good morning, Crystal Sims. Grab your coffee, you guys. Also, I've got water sitting by. I'm gonna sip on my coffee for a minute. Ooh, that was hot. I took a big swig. All right, before we get started, I want to thank our sponsors. Most importantly, let's do that now. Kimmy Christian, Tiffany Witzy, and Rose Hernandez. So thank you to those guys for sponsoring today. Good morning. Christina's here. Rachel K. just finished the Monday workout. Awesome job, Rachel K. Melita's here. Tasha's signing in. Tasha Sims, Tasha Bradley, Emily Harper. All right, you guys, let's start with a sumo squat today for our first warm-up activity. There's Andrea. Let's go legs wide and a little light, slow sumo squat right here. Get those hip flexors warmed up. Now, we won't be doing much lower body today, but as you know, it all works together. Good morning, Anita. So a couple of our activities, like the inchworm or like the push press, you will be engaging the whole system. Good morning, Enid. That's it. All right, when you come up, make sure you press forward with your hips and squeeze. There you go. Good job on those sumo squats. Get your blood pumping. Wake up, bodies. I know all of us are only about 30 minutes from being in the bed, but let's wake up slowly. Now let's do some lateral lunges. Push off, that's it. I'm surprisingly not too terribly sore from yesterday, which is a good sign. A little bit of fatigue, but as I'm taking inventory of my body, nothing is terribly damaged. If there is something sore today, remember that movement is going to help that soreness work itself out. One more. Now let's switch to the other side. Here we go. Push off. Good. You should feel a nice stretch there in your inner thigh. So we've got supersets today. We've actually got six different mini sections of your workout. Each one should take about, one more. Each one should take about 8 to 10 minutes, okay? Let's do some arm circles. Good. I can feel my breathing is already changing, okay? There's some physiological signs that your body's warming up. It's requiring more airflow. Reverse those circles. You feel a little awareness, maybe even a burn. Ranja, good morning. Carol, good morning. Yolandria is here. Yes. Andrea Perkins is here. All right, you guys, shake out those arms. Now let's do a back fly overhead press just with body weight only. Good. We want to limber up those joints, wake up the muscles. Yes. Shelanie's one of our new moms. She's got a baby at home. She's joining us until the baby wakes up. I love it, Shelanie. Way to get it in. Yes. so proud of you for bouncing back. She worked out with us her entire pregnancy, had the baby. Now she's back to exercise again. All right, last one. Out and overhead press. Again, shake out those muscles. Next up, let's just do something to get our heart pumping. We always do jumping jacks. Let's do some side to side hops. Here we go. Hop, hop on one foot. Hop, hop, good. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 more. 9, move those arms. 8, 7, get that momentum. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. See you, Michael. He's got to work early this morning. He's out the door. Probably going to come back for a second trip, knowing him. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and get started, okay? Good morning, Andrea Perkins. Andrea, we learned it is a very small world. We learned yesterday that one of her 30-year co-workers at Ford Credit is my sister-in-law, Carol Clark. So it is a very small world, Andrea. So great that we have a mutual friend. Isn't that funny? The world is always smaller than we realize. All right, here's what we're gonna do. Do you guys remember the push press? I'll demonstrate with a lighter weight, and then on your second set, you can go a little bit heavier, okay? It looks like this. You're gonna hold your weights. You're gonna have a tiny load period, so it looks like this. And you're gonna jump out of it, okay? So it's almost as if, imagine in your head, you're getting underneath the barbell, even though we're using hand weights, okay? A push press. Ready? Here we go, Andrea. Let's do it. First round is 8. And 1, 1, and back down. 2, it's a small squat. 3, 3, 4, 5, 3 more. 6, 7, 1 more. 8, good, and bring it down. Each round on that, we're gonna add 2. We're gonna add 2 repetitions, okay? So again, if you wanted to just do a straight shoulder press, you're welcome to do that. But I want you to think of some explosiveness in that quick load, jump out of it, okay? Here we go. Your second movement is a push-up. Go to your mat. Any way you can do these push-ups. So whether you go to your knees or you do a few military, you just gotta do a push-up. Ready? We've got 8 push-ups to get to. Go to your mat. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, push, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. Oh, first push-ups of the morning. Those felt hard. Not gonna lie. All right, second set of your push press. If you can here, if you're feeling comfortable with that form, go ahead and go to the next heavier level. I'm gonna go from 12s up to 15s. Here we go. Ready? Push press for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, push, 8, 9, 10, good, come out of it. It's a subtle hop, right? It's a subtle little movement, but it gets the heart rate going, doesn't it? All right, go to your mat. We've got 10 push-ups. Do your very best, you guys. Try to do the military push-up and keep your knees up. Then go to the knees. There's a kitty cat. Odie, it's coming to say hi. We're doing something here, pal. I've got to do some push-ups. Clear out. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, it's gonna get squished. 5, get to 10, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, man, those are tough. Come on, arms. Wake up. Wake up. All right, have you got anything heavier you wanna use for your last set? Now, I've been eyeballing these 20s. It's early in the day, but I have a good feeling. If we have anybody else out there, Barbara, I'm thinking of you. Melita, I'm thinking of you. Grab your 20 pounders. Here we go. Push press for 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4 more. 9. Push. 10. 11. Down. Maybe the only place we use those 20s today. Ah, y'all, my heart is up. All right, let's go down for your last set of push-ups. Again, do your very best. Modify as needed, Jeanette. You got this. We got to get to 12. After this, we get a water break. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right, just sit here for a second. Breathe. All right, we got Melita did team 20. I love it. All right, take a second. Here is your break in between circuits. All right, we just took it from 0 to 10. Perceived exertion quickly. If you were not already awake, hopefully you are now, okay? Here's your next two exercises, y'all. You've got a tricep overhead extension, and then we're gonna reverse grip it and bicep curl, okay? Normally we curl this way. This is still a curl, but it's mostly a shoulder movement, okay? Here we go. Ooh, I'm sweating now. Let's do it. Grab a pair of hand weights. Remember, we're gonna go overhead with these. If you have trouble going over your head, you're gonna do a kick back instead of an overhead. Malene said, I did not love the 20, that was hard. That was hard for me too. Here we go. Overhead tricep extensions. Split your stance and 1, 2, but we did it anyway. 3, 4, keep sweating. 5, that's it, Bradley. 6, come on, Carol. 7, 8, 9, 10, get to 20, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, keep going, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Oh man, bring it down. Shake it out, all right? That was triceps. Now we're gonna go for the overhand curl. Ready? Fingers facing your body. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. I'm feeling that in my forearm. 4, 5. It doesn't exactly feel like 6, a traditional curl. 7, does it? 8, 9, 10. I'm wishing I grabbed a lighter weight. 11, oh man. 12, I gotta finish here. 13, 14, 15, curl. 16, 17, come on, Crystal Sims. 18, 19, last one, and 20. Good stuff. All right, that is the first round. We've got two more rounds of that. So I really felt that right through here in my forearms. More on this than here. But that's good, waking up some new muscle. Ready? Second set, tricep overhead extension. On this, I typically split my stance. Put those weights together and overhead. One, two, lock in your core. Three, four, that's it, Shalini. Five, six, keep pressing. Seven, eight, nine, come on, Andrea. 10, 11, keep breathing. 12, 13, 14, 15, five more. Four, keep breathing. Three, two, and one. Man, that second set was tough. All right, I learned the hard way on that one. I'm gonna have to go back to a lighter weight on my overhand grip. All right, go back to your bicep curls. Truthfully, it's quite a bit more forearm engagement than I was expecting. Here we go for 20. One, two, that's it. Three, imagine you're holding a barbell. Four, five, and those two hand weights. Six are connected. Seven, or let's say you have a barbell. Eight, you can use that here. Nine, good job, Christina. 10, that's it, Ranja. 11, 12, 13, I'm starting to hit failure. Oh, 14, if you need a little break. 15, take it. 16, and then jump back in. 17, 18, 19, and 20. Oh man. All right, before we do that last set, I just need a quick shake out. My arms are dead, dead arms. We're gonna go back into our final set of overhead extensions. Now, if you feel like you can go heavier here, I feel like maybe I could. I feel like maybe I have a little bit more. You're doing great, Kenya. That's my girl. All right, I'm gonna try it with, dang it. Might regret this later. Here we go. You can always go lighter. One, but you cannot go heavier. Two, three, come on, triceps. Four, five, six, we're about. Seven, growing new muscle. Eight, nine, 10, so we have to adequately. 11, 12, stress the muscle. 13, 14, 15, that's it. 16, come on, Enid. 17, 18, 19, and 20. Oh, so how do we know if that was the right weight? If on the last 3 to 5, you experienced a little bit of failure, meaning cannot do one more. If you're at that feeling, you use the right weights, okay? All right, here we go. Can't even pick those up that way. Last set, I'm using my tens again. Come on, Kenya, we got this. Lock your elbows in. One, two, these are surprisingly three, hard. Four, five, it's probably because six, we do them rarely. Seven, that's it, Becky. Eight, come on, Barbara. Nine, 10, 11, 12, you got it, Crystal. 13. Take a quick break. 14. 15. 16. Four more. 17. 18. 19. One more. And 20. Oh, it's funny. I could feel it in my biceps, but I was feeling it more on the top section of my bicep. Isn't that strange? Let's see. Becky's a failure. My weights will not stay straight. Okay. So if you're wanting to curl in a little bit, that's totally fine. Okay. We'll get there. We'll get there on those, Crystal. That's a little bit of a weird movement. And I was finding my elbows wanted to come away from the lock too. Weird. Okay, we will work on that movement. Shalini said my left arm can't stay straight. Okay, we all learned a little something that we have some tightness issues. All right, here's what's next. The one that everybody was talking about. What is this whole inchworm business with a question mark? You guys rarely comment on the preview board, but there were so many comments. So what I thought we would do is, we would do our very best, okay? That's number one. We'll do our very best. And then each round, we're gonna add something to it, okay? We may take our rep range down and get lower and lower each time, but you guys were so funny. So let's do this. Let's start with 6 basic inchworms. I just like to have a little creativity in our day. Here we go, 6 basic inchworms. And then on the second round, we're gonna add 2. Ready? Stretch out your legs. Here we go, inchworms. Feet to the mat, excuse me, hands to your mat, and walk it out. Hold it in a plank. Walk it back up. Such a basic movement, right? If you need to, bend those knees, okay? Not everybody's at the same flexibility point. So if you need to, slight bend in your knees. 3, walk it out. Good. 3, walk it up. 3 more. See, this isn't so bad. 4 out. That's it, Tanya. Come on, Tanya Morton. You gotta love an inchworm. When I say 6, that's not getting a side eye. That's not earning me a side eye. That's when you say, thank you, coach. 6 out, you're welcome. Good. All right, 6, not so bad. That was our warm-up round. Now the single side Y, I want you to grab a light weight. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna hold the weights in front, really as if we were gonna do a bicep curl, okay? What you're gonna do is, all the way up, all the way up, okay? It's almost like we're going from the side, all the way up. We're the dial on a clock, okay? Good morning, Q! Ready? We've got 8 each side. 1, and down. 1, good. 2, and down. 2, that's it. 3, and 3, get to 8. 4, you've got this, Becky. And 4, halfway. 5, you're keeping it in front. 5, just slightly, that's it. 6, all the way up. 6, 2 more. 7, 7, 1 more. 8, 8, yes. All right, set those weights down. We're back to inchworms, okay? You have a couple options here. You can do the basic 6. That's gonna be your minimum. Now, I know we have some people in class that can do more than that, so that's where I want you to climb a little bit. We're gonna increase the rep range 6 to 8, and I want you to add something in that you can do with it. So you're either gonna walk it out, plank tap, or you're gonna do a push-up, okay? Those 2 different variations. I'm gonna do 8 with a push-up. Here we go. Walk it out. Walk it out. Push-up. So if you cannot do a push-up, I want you to plank tap it. Here's 2. 2, walk it out. 2, walk it back in. Up, squeeze your tush at the top. 3, out. 3, push up. And you get such a good long break. 4, that's it, Shalini. 4, walk it out. 4, push up. Here's 5. 5, walk it out. 5 out, push up. 3 more. Here's 6, that's your minimum. 6, 6. Here's 7, 7 out, 7 push. Last one, y'all, keep sweating. Here's 8 out, 8. Push and walk it back in. Woo! Y'all, at this point, you should feel sweat coming down, okay? We've got our heart rates up sufficiently. Grab those light weights. It's time for the side raise. I think 8 was a good number. Let's go for 9 each side. Ready? Hold it like this. I always tend to put my thumb on the weight. I don't know why I do that, but it seems to work for me. Here we go. 1, 1, 2. You should feel this in your shoulders. 2, in your back. 3, 3. That's it, Shanette. 4, this works best. 4 with light weights. 5, I'm using 10 pounders. 5, you can use. 6, keep that arm as straight as possible. 7, you got it. 8, let's do one more for good measure. 9 up, and 9 up. Oh, man, so I was just thinking a little bit about those of you who said that when they did this, they couldn't keep that arm straight. There's probably some old injuries in there somewhere, right? Whenever our hands can't quite do what we want them to do, or our shoulders, it's probably some kind of impingement that I don't want you to push it. Now, if it helps to kind of work out the kinks, then absolutely do that. But sometimes our bodies just don't want to move that way, okay? Oh, with the 12 pounders, okay. See, look at Melita throwing down the gauntlet on me. That's what I love about you, Mel. You're always challenging me. All right, this round, again, we're gonna add to the inchworm. If you guys want to, you can add a renegade row. You can add a push-up. I just want you to get creative. You could even add a leg raise, a little leg kickback, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my weight down there at the end of my inchworm so that when I walk it down, I'm gonna row it, and I'm gonna walk it back. Those 3 options. Minimum six, just basic, okay? Here we go. Walk it out. And 1, 1, walk it back up. Here's 2 inchworm. 2, renegade, walk it back up, squeeze, 3, that's it, Dee Dee, 3, that's it, Ranja, walk it back up. Here's 4, walk it up, squeeze. Here's 5, walk it out. 5, try something different. Here's 6, that's your minimum. 2 more for all my overachievers. Seven. Walk it out. Seven. Seven. Last one. This is what I call the Aller. Do everything you can do on the inchworm, okay? Walk it out, row it, push it up, leg it. Here we go, walk it out, push it up, row it, tap it, leg it, walk it back up. Turn it up, all right, who had fun with that? Just me? I'm adding in an orthopedic boot. Oh gosh, can ya? What? All right, you guys, last one is our single Ys. And since Melita said the 12s were working fine, we're gonna pick up the 12s, stinker. Let's see how fine those are working. We're gonna move it up to 10 reps. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, that's it, Kenya. Seven, eight, nine, be careful, Kenya. 10, that's halfway. 11, 12, do what you can. 13, and most of all, listen to your body. 14, 15, not bad, but definitely heavier. 16, 17, 18, 19, one more, and 20, yes. All right, set those down. That is our final round of, I need, probably need some water at this point. That is our final round of set three, okay? Moving on to circuit four, you guys. A couple things are happening. You should be sweating at this point. Your arms are starting to feel like jelly. You're starting to look at the clock and go, are we done yet? We are halfway. Next up, we've got a ball tricep pullover, okay? What it looks like, you're right, that wasn't too bad with those 12s. Agreed, agreed, that was a good call, Melita. All right, with the ball, what you're gonna wanna do is lean back on the ball. This is where you're on your back, and you're gonna pull the weight over, and then the bottom of the weight's gonna tap your belly button. So you're gonna need something a little bit heavier. Let's start with that 20 pounder. If you don't have anything lighter, you could use a kettlebell on this, or just use the heaviest weight you've got. But the key thing is, when you go into position, so let's roll it out. The weight is standing up here. You want your palms to the sky. So many people try to hold it this way. It's high five the sky, okay? So your palms are up, you're wrapping your thumb and your pointer finger like an L shape around the base of the weight, okay? You're gonna go over your head, pull those abs, stretch, 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 and tap, okay? So it's working your arms and your core on this one. Ready? Overhead, and tap. Two, two, three, three, and when you let that weight fall, four, in a controlled manner, five, you should feel a stretch in your abs, six, six, seven, seven, that's it, Ranja, eight, eight, nine, nine, we gotta get to 15, 10, 10, 11, who feels it in their abs? 12, 12, 13, 13, two more, 14, 14, one more, 15, And 15. Good. Roll it all the way up. Second movement, you're going to still use the ball, but we're going to do a static movement. This is, we've done this before. It's a pectoral squeeze. Amisa's going to catch the replay. Okay, sounds good, Amisa. She's got to get to work early. What you're going to do is bend your elbows and squeeze. Now visually, I want you to think about squeezing right here, these pectoral muscles. Ready? Here we go for 15. One, two, squeeze. Three, four, release. Five, six, seven, lead with your elbows. Eight, squeeze. Nine, 10, 5, 4, that's it, 3, 2, 1, good. I want you to hold it, hold that squeeze, hold, 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 pulse for 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, man, I could feel those, I could definitely feel those. All right, quick sip of coffee. Round two coming up, Catherine. All right, y'all. If you feel like you could go heavier on that, go ahead and grab a 30. I think that's all I got left. I've got a, man, getting it off the weight rack is the hardest part. All right, if you want to go heavier, on that pullover, I trust you can do it, okay? This is one where you have more power than you realize. You just gotta keep that good form, okay? Here we go. Too far away. Let me readjust you guys. That's better. All right, roll it back. High five the sky. Here we go. One, palms up. Two, three, four, five, six, pull it over, seven, feel it in those abs, eight, nine, that's it, Ranja, 10, you got it, Shanette, 11, we used to do these every week, 12, 13, woo, 14, and 15, good, roll it up. Now, honestly, the heavier you go, the more you're going to feel that in your core as opposed to your arms. All right, second one, still using the ball. We've got the pectoral squeeze. Here we go, second round of this. Grab the ball, and one, two, three, four, that's it. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, good. Now I want you to hold, hold it, squeeze. Let's pulse for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and you're out of there. So you should be feeling that through here, okay? That squeeze, that static hold. Great job, Tawana. Here we go, ready? We're gonna go right into our third set. Grab something heavy. Just getting it up off the ground is the heavy part. Ready, Barbara? Roll it back. Here we go. High five the sky. Wrap your hands around the weight. And one, two, nice and controlled. Three, that's it, Andrea. Four, you got it, Erica. 5, 6, come on, Carol, 7, 8, 9, tricep pullover, 10, 5 more, 5, now I've adjusted, 4, 3, 2, 1 more. Yes. All right, roll it back up. Slowly push your feet forward. All right, we've got one more set. One more set. Whoa, whoa. My stability ball is so sweaty. It's getting slippery. All right, let's finish with the pectoral squeeze. Let's go for 15 and then let's pulse for 15. Wrap your arms around, your elbows are bent. 1, 2, you got it, Shalini. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, come on, Tasha Bradley. 8, 9, 10, 5, squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1, good. Static hold. Hold, hold, squeeze. Let's pulse for 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Why was that so hard? That was painful. All right, set it to the side. Let's take a little break and regroup, okay? 4 circuits done, you guys. We are right on track with time. We're gonna do a plank pull through and a pectoral fly, and then we'll do our finisher, which is all back. Yes, only 2 circuits to go, and those are quickies. Ah, I'm sticking with my water challenge. It does get harder, but I've learned that if going into dinner, I can be at 100 ounces, I know I can get that last 20 ounces, like through dinner and just sipping on things the rest of the night. That is the key. All right, for these plank pull throughs, you're gonna need 1 weight. So when you go into a plank, you can reach across and pull it through and back into a plank, okay? An alternative for this, I'm so hungry. Right now you are? Oh gosh, Becky. I do eat breakfast right after class. So sometime in that 7 o'clock hour, I'm eating something. Here we go, y'all. Ready? Go into a plank. We're gonna pull it through 10 each side for a total of 20. Let's do it. And 1, 2, I'm using a 15 pound weight. 3, use whatever you've got. 4, 5, an alternative to this. 6, Andrea. 7 would be pick your plank. 8, 9, so if you're unable, 10, 11, you're halfway. 12, 13, take a little break if you need to. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Bring it down. Getting jiggy with it. Na, na, na. Getting jiggy with it. Na, na, na. Getting jiggy with it. Na, 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 na. All right, grab some light weights. This is our 90s fitness mix. Here we go, y'all. Ready? Pectoral fly. What it looks like, light weights. You're gonna come up to right here, 90 degree angle, okay? And bring those elbows together. Ready? 10, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now if you're unable, 5 to close that gap, 6 and get those elbows together, 7, no worries, 8, it's a work in progress, 9, get as far as you can, and 10. Another option here would be, if everything you've got at this point feels too heavy, that's a movement that if you just do this, body weight only, okay? I'm thinking of you, Carol. We want to keep that shoulder healthy, so just pulling it together might be enough on your shoulders. Let's go back into the plank pull through. Ready, Tawana? Go back down into a plank. We're gonna knock these out. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's it, Yolandria. 6, keep going. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 5 more. 16, 17, 18. Pull it through. 19 and 20. Woo! Deep breath. Those are tough. The one tip I'll give you is to try and keep your hips facing the ground. You don't want to have a lot of hip movement on that. Here we go. Pectoral flies. Stand up. Pick your weights. Something light. Go up to 90 degrees. Keep it right here. And bring those elbows together. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4 more, 7, 8, woo, arms, 9 and 10, bring it down, last set of your plank pull throughs. If you want to switch this out for something heavier, you're definitely going to work your core more, the heavier the weight. Okay, so if it just feels too light for you, throw a 20 in there, Melita, because I want you to feel here in your obliques, Norma. Good morning. Here we go, Tasha Sims. Go down into a plank. Keep your hips square to the ground. 1, that's it, Shanette. 2, 3, pull across. 4, 5, you got it, Becky. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10, last set of these. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh man, it's crazy. I started feeling that in my glute. I don't know why. I did though. All right, stand it up. Let's see. Bradley's got to get to work. It is that time of day. I was trying to get finished before you had to run to work. We've got a finisher for everybody else. Here we go. Last set of these. 1, and then we're moving on. 2, finish strong. 3, 4, remember, 5, body weight only. 6, if this is too heavy. 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, set them down. Now, we have got coming up our back YTMs. YTMs. We're gonna do 3 sets of it. We've done these before. This is another one. When you hit failure with your lightest weights, and I'm talking, start with the 8s, move to the 5s, grab 3s if you have to, you're gonna do Y, T, M, with emphasis on your back, okay? Think about squeezing. Y, T, M, okay? You gotta think mind, muscle connection on this one, okay? She said, noodle arms, said Becky. That's what we wanna hear. I'm gonna start with my eights. Starting with the eights. Yes, ma'am. Here we go, YTMs. Put your weights on top of your quads, right here, thumbs at the top, and Y to the sky. Y, T, M, that's one, two, 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 three, three T, three M, four, 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 five Y, five T, five M, six, six, six. Oh man, failure. Here we go. Seven, seven, seven. Come on, Andrea Davis. Eight, Andrea Perkins. Eight, eight. Man, set those down, shake it out. Set one down, okay? Are you thinking about the muscles you're working? Otherwise, you're just gonna throw it up and your shoulders are gonna take over. We're really trying to get the shoulders out of the equation, even if you have to hinge it forward a little bit to get that back muscle engaged. Ready? Here we go, second set. YTMs, let's do it. Quads for balance, let's go. And one, one T, one M, two, two, failure with eights, two, three, three, that's what I wanna hear, three, four, four, this is little weights, four, five Y, five T, five M, oh God, six Y, six T, six M, two more, seven Y, seven T, seven M, one more, Y, T, M, set it down. Shake it out. Dance break. Can y'all hear this? Everybody, everybody. One more set. One more set. We can do this. Come on, y'all. Push through, Mel. YTMs. Ready, Freddy? Here we go. I'll do it from this angle. Ready? Here we go. Y, T, M. That's one, two, 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 three, Y, three, T, three, M, four, 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 five, Y, five, T, five, M. Oh God, I'm starting to fail. Six, Catherine. Six. Six. Two more. Here we go. Seven. 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 One more. Eight. 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 That's all I got. That is all she wrote, you guys. Awesome job. All right, let's shake out those muscles. Shake it out. Shake it out. Noodle arms. Let's just hang your arms to the floor. Get a little bit of circular pendulum. Other side. Good. Now, if you do have a shoulder impingement, this is a great thing to do with a small weight. So if you're noticing Your shoulders do not go where you want them to. Great job, Angie. Then I want you guys to do some of those exercises at the end of class to pull that scar tissue, okay, and start to stretch it. Switch. Great job, Andrea. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Tasha. You are so welcome. Deep breath up. Reach for the center of your back. I love it when we do an hour of just arms. We didn't do a ton of chest today because we did some chest yesterday. Great job, Q. All right, let's cross one leg over. This is just for yesterday's legs. Ah, wonderful job, Juanita, Andrea, Tawana. Late, but she made it. You're welcome. You were right on schedule, Tawana. Switch. We're stretching out these legs. Quick funny story, you guys. We went and rode bikes yesterday, and I was climbing to the top of this hill that I used to be able to make look easy, okay? But I had not climbed this particular hill in a year, and it's just right around the corner from my house. Catherine, you probably know this hill. Great job, Bruce. So I'm climbing the hill just barely, but I'm sucking in so much wind that I inhale a bug. I just pulled it straight in. So Spen, great job, Andrea, Beverly, Jackie. So I end up spending the next 20 minutes, Erica, coughing up this bug, and I finally get it out, but it had me so aggravated. See you, Melita. Awesome job, Yolandria. It was very humbling, okay? It made me realize I have work to do on these hills. When you have not done something in a while and you literally feel like your heart's gonna explode and my lungs are gonna explode and my quads were gonna explode, it was difficult. Suck that bug right down. I never physically got to lay eyes on the bug, but I could feel something in there. Yes. Have a wonderful day, Christina, Carol. It happens. It happened. All right, y'all, keep drinking that water. Remember, water challenge in full effect, Dee Dee. If you're still doing the 75 hard, we're on about I'm on day 10. Yes, you know that big ass hill. Yes. It's all you can do to get up the hill. You're not trying to swat bugs away. Keep up with your water, you guys. Of course, this is bottle one for me, and I've taken one sip, so I'm probably gonna hang up and chug this. Have a wonderful day, you guys. Hopefully your arms felt strong today, and I will see you tomorrow for leg day. Tomorrow is a very special day, because after leg day, at noon, I go get my second vaccine. So we've got a tentative schedule for Thursday. Everything's normal Wednesday, but depending on how I feel tomorrow after my Moderna, we might have a modified schedule on Thursday, okay? Bye, y'all. Love y'all. Mwah. See ya, Andrea.